Good morning on this 30th day of November. Guys, it's the first day of Vlogmas. I'm so excited. So this is what it looks like every morning when I wake up. I have my timers set so that, you know, this little Christmas tree here on my kitchen counter is on, my gingerbread house is on, and then my big 12-foot tree is on, just so I can enjoy the glow of the tree when I first wake up. It is also, I'm so excited to tell you, the first snow of the season. What? How wonderful is it? There's snow falling this morning. I can't think of a better way to start off Vlogmas. So, as y'all know, I start filming on the last day of November. That way I can edit and upload, and the video will be live tomorrow. Put you down here. Let's make us some coffee.
First things first, right?
Let's get this Vlogmas started off with a bang, baby. Alrighty, so this is the way I've been drinking my coffee as of late. My beloved sugar-free chocolate creamer. A little bit of that. A little bit of sugar-free vanilla. Just a splash of that. Not much. And then a bit of half and half. If you're wondering why I am out of breath, girl, I just went outside and tried to move my mother-in-law's tongue. That is a plant my mom gave me, and I busted the pot. It's snowing on it. So, let's just get this holiday season off to a bang. Let's throw us in a topper here. Oh my gosh, yes. How festive are we? When that first drink of coffee hits. So, here's the plan for today. I have taken a new job, guys, and I have a lot of trainings coming up. I have one, there's like a training I'm doing this week. There's a training every week until the new year. So, because the new year, we're a new program that I work in, and it goes live on January 1st. So, between now and January 1st, training's out the wazoo every day. So, I'm gonna drink my coffee. It's only 7:15. My shift starts at 8. So, yeah, I'll probably run and get me a shower and just get prepped for the day, you know? And, yeah, I will check back in a little while, guys. Hey, guys. So, it is currently 1:25, and we are on lunch break with work. So I thought I'd talk to y'all a little bit about like my new job. Y'all know I work for the last few years, I've worked in insurance in Kentucky as a nurse. So it's a managed care organization, meaning it's a large insurance company that I work for. But I particularly work in the branch where we serve the Medicaid population. So in this particular job, I actually am a nurse educator. So I'll be doing education. It's kind of like quality. If you've ever heard like in healthcare, like, you know, a quality job or performance improvement, something like that, that is kind of what my role is. So the snow is melting. Thought I would show you that. Did any of y'all order anything with Black Friday and all that? Listen, I ordered a ton of stuff. So let me get this Sephora order together and I'll show you what I got today from Sephora. Okay, so get my phone here just in case it goes off. I only got this stuff on Black Friday. It came really fast. I did get a couple of Huda lipsticks to try. Just because they look pretty on the site, I got Trophy Wife and Heartbreaker. Heartbreaker, it said, was like a pinky red. You know, I'm always looking for a good alternative to that limited edition ColourPop lipstick that was my holy grail red lipstick. These wear off on me. I tried them both on today, and Oh, I'm not a huge fan. I hate to say that. I'm really not. For my birthday gift, I did go ahead and get Charlotte Tilbury Magic Cream and then this Pillow Talk. Is it a lip jewel? I think it's what it's called. I have fallen in love with the ink. Is it Incredible? Incredible? I don't know. It's the Roller Baby Rollerball Gloss. Like a Honey, Rolling Like a Honey is my, the only one that I've ever had. It's my fave. Like, I love it. And then I did get Choose Your Happy to try. And it's just kind of like a lilac color. Those are so good. Your lips look so juicy and wet. Oh, so a couple of samples to try. Don't even know. And I did spend 100 points on a Kat Von D liner. Have you all tried this hair perfume? My friend Wendy bought it in the Rouge sale, and hers had this weird black dot in it. I don't know. I don't even know if she got a refund on that. I'm thinking that she did, but I did get that. That might have been 100 points too. I can't remember. But okay, so y'all know my idol in this life, if I had one, I try not to have an idol, but somebody who I would love to fall in their footsteps would be Martha Stewart. Like, I love all things Martha Stewart. And I'm constantly like looking at her beauty regimen, things like that, because she's beautiful. I think she's 74. Woman be looking fabulous. For so many years, she has shared this bronzer. It's the Bobbi Brown bronzing powder in natural. And everything that she talks about with her makeup, she always mentions this bronzer. It's just a pretty kind of matte, neutralish kind of bronzer. So we'll try that. And then she, like it in Us Weekly and stuff, she's done a What's in My Bag. She always has Bobbi Brown blushes. And from what I can tell by looking at some of her posts, this one appears to be one of the ones that she had. This is in pale pink. Okay. So we'll try both of those. I love a bright blush. This one looks very, it's not very bright. It looks like it would be brighter in the pan, right? Not very bright. All right, so that's all I got from Sephora. So I think that is all I'll get in terms of packages today, because I don't think anybody else ships as fast as Sephora. But I did order several things on Black Friday. Sorry, my hair is like a mess. But I did order several things on Black Friday. There were so many good sales. There's this place called Backcountry, and they had a lot of their Patagonia stuff on sale, so I got me like a Patagonia pullover. I'm not much for fleece, like, or Sherpa. Like, I'm just hot natured, okay? Mama runs hot. I can't do Sherpa and things like that because it burns me up. But there's a little boutique near my house where they have a lot of like Simply Southern stuff. And there was this really, it was more of a slickety kind of material. I don't know how to even explain it. Not like fur, but slinkier and silkier than Sherpa. And when I felt it, I thought, I love that. So I found one online. I got it for, I think, 20 bucks, something like that. So I figured that was pretty good. What else did I get for what? Oh, okay. My friend Leslie, who has been on my channel several times, she does a lot of aesthetics. And she was talking about this new serum that came out this year from Skin Medica. And so online you can get these products, because I think ideally you want an esthetician or, you know, a dermatologist or somebody to prescribe these things to you. Okay, I'm gonna have to take this call. I'll be back. All right, I am back. Look at my mug here. So my beloved friend Dina, when I did my pet sitting here in my neighborhood, her dog Shakira got me this mug for Christmas last year. And sadly enough, Dina moved away this year. So drinking out of this mug is bittersweet because I think of my friend, but it makes me miss her all at the same time, you know? But today is a good day. learning a lot with this new job, and we're in training pretty much now until the new year. And I think it's going to be really rewarding. I actually am involved in this program in Kentucky with foster children, so I think it will be so rewarding. And when I went through the interview process last month, I had a few different interviews, and after my first one, because we discussed foster and the Department for Juvenile Justice and things like that in the state, and I had so much time to think about it till my next interview. And when I went for that next interview, they asked me why I wanted to work in foster. And I said, I was never in foster care, thank God, because I can't imagine how horrific that would be. And I said, but that being said, I can sympathize with other people who have abandonment and alienation from a parent, because one of mine did that, So I think that's where a lot of my motivation comes in working with this particular patient population. And I think it will be extremely rewarding, to think of at 41, okay, soon to be 42, a cop showing up in the middle of the night and a social worker handing me a garbage bag and saying, pack you a bag of stuff, you've got 15 minutes, and then taking me somewhere where I don't know anyone. That would be terrifying at my age here, present day, And to think of a child going through that, that breaks my heart. And every time we have to watch videos of kids who have been in foster, we have, members who are in the foster system that are on our videos, I cry with every one of them. That breaks my heart. So I think it's very rewarding to work in a job where you have a passion for people to do better and to step up, any way you can improve the foster care system. I think that would be very rewarding, just for the folks that are unfortunately in that system, So I'm excited about what this job may bring, and we're still learning. It's still brand new. I got 15 minutes left on my lunch break. So, a good thing with this job, it starts earlier in the day and it ends earlier of the evening. So my last job started at 8:30 and I worked till 5:30. So anyways, a great day, a great start to Vlogmas. It's a good day today. I'm very happy today and just feel good and positive, right? Are y'all ready for Christmas? I need to start. That's the deal. I did buy a few Christmas gifts this weekend, but I was like, Erica, I can buy myself stuff. I can't believe it snowed the very first day of shooting for Vlogmas, because it has been unusually warm here in Kentucky. Something else I'm doing. I am not Catholic. I'm just, of Christian faith. And that being said, my favorite church that I have ever went into, because I went all over Italy. I've been to the Sacre Coeur in Paris and Notre Dame. And I've been to basically every famous European cathedral. I've been to the ones in New York, just a lot of famous churches. I've been to them. I think probably your most famous one would probably be, at the Vatican, where the Pope is, I don't know if people who in Italy would say that, but definitely I think folks here would probably say that's your most famous church. It was breathtaking. It was beautiful. But my favorite one I've ever been into is where the Leaning Tower of Pisa is. There's the cathedral that's straight across from it. I think there's a little walkway that joins them. It seems like there was. I'm not lying to you. When we walked in that building, you could feel the presence of God there. And I knew, as soon as I walked in, I thought, if I lived in Italy, this is the exact church that I would go to, because I loved it. I'll never forget the way I felt being inside that church, So one of my friends on Facebook, she is Catholic, and she posted something over the weekend that was about the Advent. Are y'all even familiar with it? I don't even think you have to be Catholic necessarily to to do the Advent or whatever. I mean, I have an Advent calendar, you know, thing. I don't even know if that's the same thing, you know, like if it's even related, but I started reading about it yesterday, and basically what it is looking forward to Christ's coming in your everyday life. So it's a build up to, you know, when his birth on Christmas, you know, the day that we celebrate his birth at least. And so during the month of December, you pray every day, getting excited for Christ's day of birth, you know, that we celebrate. And then it's also about getting excited about having him in your everyday life, and then to his, you know, coming once again, if you're of the Christian faith. So I loved reading about it, and I love the idea of let's get excited about what this holiday is for, right? It's about Jesus, you know, it's about if you are a Christian. And if you're not, I'm not here to push religion down your throat. You know, the only reason I speak of it is because I believe there's power in prayer, and you know, it's definitely a part of who I am. So don't feel like I'm pushing it down your throat. It's just, you know, I invite you, if you've never really been familiar with Advent, like me, then maybe look into it, and maybe you can do it with me. So here's what I learned. There's four candles that you light, okay? There's three purple, and there's one kind of pinkish rose, okay? So the three purple stands for hope, love, and then the third week you light that pink one, and that one is for joy, and then the last one is for peace. So yesterday, because I think it's four Sundays before Christmas, am I right? I don't know. Advent started yesterday, just yesterday, so you can still do this if you want to. I lit my first candle, which is for hope, and I found some Bible scriptures that you're supposed to read. You know, even though I'm not Catholic, I've always felt a true drawing to Catholicism. There's no denying that. And I bought a rosary. Sorry. And I bought a rosary at the Vatican, you know, when I was there. So, and I have this like little booklet thing that's like how to pray the rosary. Well, I found this adorable little woman on YouTube last night, and I just prayed along with her, you know, and followed her. And, you know, I feel so happy today from it. I don't think there's any denying it. So I'm excited to do Advent, if you all are. I did order a couple of little books on Amazon. Like, one's a prayer journal for the next 52 weeks, and then the other two, I think, are related to Advent and praying the rosary. So I'll link everything down below in case you're interested in getting them too. But yeah, so whenever you, I guess, do Advent or whatever. So if you're going to do Advent, I think you have like a wreath with those four candles, okay? This is what I learned. And the wreath is evergreen, and it's in this circle because it's unending, like Christ's love for us. So, you know, he's the Alpha and Omega, right? And it's green because it's, you know, like full of hope and life and that kind of thing. So then you have your four candles. Well, honey, I just went out and made me one because, you know, this is new to me. I don't know really what I'm doing. So I just clipped some evergreen from my shrubs outside and made me a wreath. And then there's my four candles. And I just, you know, it's plastic candles that I had on hand. I didn't have any candle holders, so those are actually toothpick holders. But I did it, right? And then here, of course, is my rosary that I prayed with, and my Bible. But you can pray any way you feel led to, right? That's what I believe. All right, my lunch is about over. About 10 minutes. So I'm going to go ahead and drink my coffee, maybe grab a snack, and I'm going to get back to work. And guys, I'll check in this evening. Guys, it is 8 o'clock. Like, not even. Okay, it's 5 till. Look at my hair. I just had to put my sweatshirt back on because I'm so cold. I've been doing this little drink at night using my unsweetened vanilla almond milk. Let me get my stuff and I'll show you. My saucepan, I had just washed it. So that's why it's wet. It was in the dishwasher. So I'm going to do a cup of water. Now, I like this, but I'm a cinnamon lover. If you're not a cinnamon lover, you may not love it, okay? But the cinnamon has a lot of health benefits. It stabilizes your blood sugar. I'm going to do a whole teaspoon. That's quite a bit of cinnamon, okay? And let me get my honey. I'm going to do raw Manuka honey. And I'm just going to do half a teaspoon. I also have just regular, like, raw honey, but I'm going to use this little guy and do half a teaspoon. And I'm just going to cook that till it's, like, nice and hot and bubbly. And then basically all I do is take a mug and fill it with my vanilla unsweetened almond milk. And I do have to, like, put the mug once everything is kind of finished cooking in the microwave just so it's nice and hot and bubbly. But it's a nice little nighttime drink. Like I said, the cinnamon kind of helps stabilize your blood sugar. Mine is normal, my blood sugar, but my A1C did go up. Did I tell y'all? Okay, so I gained 40 pounds last year. Yes, 40. In 1 year because, you know, we talented like that. I have lost 30 of that. So, and I wasn't even little to begin with, okay? Mama, big girl. We like to eat, all right? So, you know, we're still going to be losing. I'm not even kidding you, 40 pounds away from my goal weight. Yeah. So, you know, we a big girl. Got some work to do, but you know what? We're working on it. It has snowed here the entire day. There's not been a moment out today that snow has not been falling. I love it. And such a great start to Vlogmas, right? But I'm cold. I'm going to go put on my pajamas and I'm going to pray the Advent. And drink my cinnamon honey tea and get ready for bed. Got my tea back here boiling. It's been a pleasure to share some of my day with you. Today was a little busy, especially with my training. Hopefully through this month, we'll spend lots of time together. Let me know what y'all would like to see. I still have like tons of clothes that I have got recently that I could do like a try-on. Listen to me. I'm not a TikToker, okay? I have done 2 TikToks in my life, okay? But I'll have to end this video with one of my TikToks because it is pretty funny. And funny note, I sent it to my new boss the first day that I got hired. She was like, Erica, that's hilarious. I was like, I'm just kidding.
So tell us, what's your dream job?
Darling, I've told you several times before, I have no dream job. I do not dream of labor.
I don't really even watch TikTok, okay? It's not who I am. But have y'all seen these leggings from Aerie? Like American Eagle Aerie. And everybody's talking about how good you look in them and whatever. They're sold out, okay? You can't get them, all right? They're the crossover ones, okay? Let me show you. Got my dinner plate in the sink, okay? Because we live in the real world. But anyways, what did I do? I went on Poshmark and found me a pair that somebody had worn twice. And I got them for $60, okay? Probably highway robbery, but we gotta know if these leggings are, you know, worth it, okay? Got my little mug here. That's what the tea be looking like. And then I just fill this up with some, you know, I like it, pretty milky. Here's the deal. If you like a really sweet beverage, you're going to want to sweeten this, okay? I'm just going to sip this. This is supposed to help with abdominal fat. Did I tell y'all that? I don't know if it does, okay? We're going to see if it does. But, you know, supposedly within a couple of weeks, you're supposed to see some abdominal fat shrinkage. I mean, I'm all about that because your girl does tend to carry weight through the midsection, okay? So, I need to heat this up because it's not going to be hot to my liking. But the regular tea, just the cinnamon, the water, and the honey, they say it's supposed to shrink belly fat. I don't know if there's any truth to that, okay? But I will be the first to say, I think it helps with craving snack foods at night, because that's when I really get hungry, and I think it does help. So, anywho, I'm going to go put on my pajamas. I'm going to wash my face. Oh, yeah, what I was saying about the clothes. Do y'all want me to do a try-on, okay? You want me to see if the airy leggings are truly worth it, all right? I'm going to tell you right now, it'd be hard to beat these Fabletics. Fabletics is kind of where it's at for me, okay? I do appreciate you taking time out of your day to spend some time with me. And guys, I'll see you tomorrow.